Coming up next, 1988 Olympic gold medalist Steve Lewis in his quest to defend his Olympic 400-meter title when we return to Barcelona.
World record holder in this event, Butch Reynolds. Lee Evans, the Olympic record holder. And in this quarterfinal, the American Steve Lewis, who growing up in Los Angeles used to race his brothers home from church in his dress shoes. In 1988 in Seoul, he became the youngest 400 gold medal winner in history, winning the gold at age 19.
Now he's the grand old age of 23, and he says he appreciates this Olympics a lot more. Says he's hungrier now, and it would mean even more than the first time.
Also here, Roberto Hernandez of Cuba, winner of the Pan American 400 run last year.
Many people feel he would have won a medal back in 88, but Cuba boycotted. And why did Hernandez start running the 400? It's because of this man, El Caballo. At age 9, he watched Alberto Wantarena win the 400 meters at the 76 Olympics.
In addition, in this heat is Roger Black of Great Britain, silver medalist at the World Championships last year.
And a member of the 4x400-meter relay team that beat the U.S. team in that event. Later, he put on a T-shirt that said, "We kicked their butts." And you can be sure the American athletes are aware of that T-shirt.
Here are the lane assignments. Hernandez 3, Lewis 5, Black 6.
Been some rough going for Steve Lewis since 1988 when he won that Olympic championship at age 19. A number of illnesses and injuries, particularly to his hamstrings. Said there were a number of times where he wanted to quit the sport. Obviously got things back together to make his second Olympic team.
And won his qualifying heat, timed in 45.14.
See an official checking the position of his foot on the starting block.
Yes, Lewis.
Steve Lewis running in lane 5.
Lewis used to go out very quickly. Now he likes to spread his speed over the whole lap of the 400 meters, and it's Black on the left of the screen who's out very fast.
Roger Black, Great Britain, lane 6 is indeed away quickly, and now Lewis is gaining on him. They're into the turn for home, Black and Lewis. And now Steve Lewis comes up to take the lead.
Black has not been very effective in this part of his race to transition to the last 100 meters. You see Hernandez looking around to start counting. The top four go on to the semi.
So it's Lewis and Hernandez easily in front of the rest of the pack. Roger Black now takes over the third spot. And it will be Simon Kemble of Kenya getting the fourth and final qualifying spot.
Lewis attempting to stop and walk across the finish line. That's a psychological maneuver to make Black feel bad. And watch where Steve Lewis overtakes Black. Black very enthusiastic in that first 200 meters. His coach Mike Whittingham says he needs to hold back more in the 200. And they came around this turn. This is where his coach wants him to pick it up, but it's Lewis that moves by him, taking command of this race.
Steve Lewis will move on to the semifinal round to be contested tomorrow as he wins his heat in a rapid 44.54 with Hernandez, Black, and Kemboy also qualified.
Second on the all-time list in the 400 meters, Danny Everett stays loose underneath the stands as he prepares for his heat, which is coming up next.
We're in the quarterfinal round of the men's 400-meter run. This heat featuring Danny Everett of the United States, the American trials winner and bronze medalist in Seoul in 1988. And Craig, I would think he's running with a lot on his mind these days.
He sort of has double trouble on his mind. One is his right Achilles. He's had trouble with his both Achilles tendons over the last few years, but the right one clearly troubling him. Wasn't even sure if he'd make it to the starting line. Says he's preparing for the worst and hoping for the best. Then there's another controversy going on. The American coaches have announced that they'll probably use Michael Johnson, the great 200-meter runner, as a member of the 4x400-meter relay. Danny Everett says that's the wrong thing to do, says that's not the proper policy, even though the policy was announced last December, really to make up for the fact that the U.S. team lost the 4x4 at last year's World Championships.
Here are the lane assignments with Danny Everett in lane 3. Everett and Steve Lewis had some harsh words for the U.S. coach.
Well, I wrote them down because they were so strong. He said Mel Rosen, the U.S. coach, is lying, double-talking, treating people childishly. He said he's lost all respect for head coach Mel Rosen. some very strong statements, and I disagree with Danny Everett. The policy was made clear last December. They said they'd take the best four guys and put them on the relay. Clearly, Michael Johnson is one of the best four guys.
Maybe the best in the world, though he has not entered in the 400-meter run. Schedule conflicts limiting him to the 200, at least schedule conflicts in his eyes.
But priority number one for Danny Everett is to get through this qualifying round of the 400 meters. His teammate Mark Witherspoon went down with an injured Achilles in the 100 semis yesterday.
Danny Everett running in lane three. Just next to him, Derek Redmond of Great Britain won his first heat yesterday in 45.03, blazing time.
It's good that Danny Everett has Derek Redmond, who we see on the left of the screen, out in front of him. He can gauge his pace off of him. But right now, Danny Everett is lagging badly. He says he's trying to run two even 200-meter runs.
Derek Redmond is the man that's really picking it up. Redmond is there, but Troy Douglas of Bermuda. And Danny Everett has some work to do as they come to the top of the home stretch. Top four advance to the semifinals.
You see Redmond looking around. He knows he's qualified easily. Danny Everett has to get up into the top four. Right now he's in fourth, moving towards third.
Redmond to Cano, and Everett will finish fourth and qualify for the semi.
He's going to have a very bad lane as a result of that finish, which will make things even more difficult for him in the semifinal. Danny Everett, very tentative coming out of the starting blocks. He told us yesterday that he would try to run two even 200-meter races to add up to 400 meters. You can see he's testing that right Achilles as he heads out of the blocks. Now here he is in lane three as they come around the last turn. You can see the large deficit that he has. Four runners well ahead of him at this point and another runner almost alongside. He's got to get up into the top four spots in order to qualify for the final. He picks it up a little and just moves into that fourth position, but doesn't try to do anything more.
So here are the official results. And Danny Everett will have a tough lane assignment as he moves to the semifinals after finishing fourth. Redmond, the winner, in 45.02. And Todd Christensen is with Danny Everett.
Thanks a lot, Tom. Danny, you know, one of the things that I think many people are concerned with, I mean, you've got a lot of American fans sitting on the edge of your seat. How is the Achilles tendon?
It's basically the same, and I'm trying to get through the rounds with as little effort as possible. Tomorrow is going to be a really important day for me. I'm going to have to really set the tone for the finals and really test it out and see if I'm going to have it.
The second backstretch particularly, you're coming up fifth. A lot of people were nervous. What was your thinking at that point?
Well, I wasn't really sure exactly where I was. It's really hard to gauge when I'm not really running my race. I just wanted to try to stay behind Derek because I knew he would be somewhere around the front. To come off the straightaway and in a good position.